All right. Welcome to Right On with John Crane, coming at you here with another edition of Taylor Ham Tuesday, bringing to you one of the best things to come out of New Jersey besides myself, the classic sandwich, Taylor Ham, egg and cheese, salt, pepper, ketchup to go on the hard roll. I can't wait to take a bite of that. Hey, I want to give a shout out to my friend Dave Hooley, Grayledge CNC. This guy is awesome. He made me this great Taylor Ham Tuesday sign a while back, and I'm happy to bring it out for this occasion here. It's been a while since I've done a Taylor Ham Tuesday. Even sporting the Mount Alamuchi Boy Scout Reservation mug here. All right, so you're probably wondering, right, where the hell has this guy been? I'm happy to be back bringing some videos here to you, and I've been really busy here in the shop getting ready for some projects that I think you guys are going to find really exciting. I think they're really exciting. So it's a big reveal today, kind of a new direction of the channel. I'm going to be bringing you some different content. I'm still going to be bringing you the content that I've been bringing for about a year now, right? I've been doing this YouTube channel since March I started, and later in this episode we're going to go back and look over some of those projects. I got about 70 videos out, and that's a lot of projects last year on this channel. So if you haven't taken a look at those videos, you can go back into the archives and there's loads of content. So exciting stuff going on, exciting projects. I feel like I should take a bite of this sandwich. And then I'm going to walk you around the shop here and show you what's going on. The classic. Oh my God. That was one good sandwich. All right, I'm giving you the Scout Crafter angle here. All right, it's Mishmash Monday. No, it's Taylor Ham Tuesday. All right, I'm going to flip this around here, and I'm going to show you guys what's going on here in the shop. I don't know if I've given a little walking tour of this shop or not over the past, maybe a little bit. Here's some of the boxes here, and I just want to say thanks to all these guys that have been supporting me, Randy Richards, Road King, Scout Crafter, John there. Here's a Rick here, back into service. He just sent out a sticker, sent me out some webbing there too. And I think it's time to stick his sticker up here. Thanks a lot. You know, these guys are just great. And this YouTube community has just been awesome. Oh, there goes the Randy Richards pin there. I'll stick that back up there. All right, on to the projects. Let me grab my coffee here, and we'll take a little walk around the shop. Here's the setup. Got the milling machine. Here's a little hint of what is to come here in the future, if you guys know what that is. And right here, all right, here's the big action. I busted through this wall into this part of the shop. Now, this was just some old storage. And if you guys saw videos in the past, right, this was just a wall right here. And I've been working hard. I ripped this all apart. I've been redoing this. I insulated this whole space here. I got the rock wool. And this place, you're going to be able to heat this over here with a match. I had to level up this floor. It's a concrete slab under here, and it was starting to sink in a corner. And I leveled up this whole slab with some dry pack. I put some sleepers down. I put insulation down. And I put this beautiful TNG down on the floor. All right, so you're wondering, what the heck is going to happen in here? All right, so you know I love machining. I love working in the shop, but I also love cooking. And as you guys know, right, I love Taylor Ham and all that kind of stuff. And I also love pizza. Now, I've been making pizza for years. So what you're looking at right here is going to be the new Right On pizza shop. And let's take a walk outside here. All right, here we are out in front of the shop. And what do we got right here? Check out this action. I'm really excited about these. You guys know what this is? Baker's Pride. This is a deck oven, a double stack deck oven. I got two of these Baker's Pride pizza ovens. These are just amazing. This is a Baker's Pride. It's a model 451. And these are some good size deck ovens. I'm going to run these on propane. So I got two of these, and I'm going to be doing some restoration work on these, as you can see. So that's going to be part of this project, is to take these ovens into the shop, redo them all, clean them all up. I'm going to go over everything inside and out, you know, redo all the propane orifices there, and, you know, inside and out, the insulation. So this is super cool here. So back into the shop here, right? This is the pizzeria, Crane Pizzeria. So I'm thinking there's going to be a big counter along here. I'm going to put these ovens back here. And I'm thinking I'm also going to make room right down here for a wood-fired pizza oven. So that'll be another build that's coming down the road. So I am just super excited about this. I think you guys are really going to love this. So lots of pizza coming your way. That's going to be part of the channel now, is working in the shop here and then over here for some pizza content. So my original goal was to have people come on, you know, the channel here. We build a project in the shop. And then we head over to the pizza shop and we make a pizza together. So I'm going to be doing all kinds of pizzas. Probably the first pizza that I make out of here is going to be New York style, of course. New Jersey style, right? All right, check out this Hobart mixer here. This is an 80-quart Hobart mixer. And, of course, I've had it sitting outside and, you know, it's got some rust. But I'm going to take this thing all apart, clean it up. This is a three-phase machine. I got the mixing bowl outside. It's a big stainless steel mixing bowl, and it has a big dough hook that goes right on here. This thing is a beast. Check this out. I don't know what this is from. If any of you guys know the year on this, or if you've used this, I imagine this machine here is out of the 50s, something like that. Check out this motor. I'll take that all apart. Right? This, I am so stoked for this project. This is super cool. I put it on some casters so I can roll it around. So I'll strip this whole thing down, paint it, clean it, get this mixing dough. So as you can imagine, it's probably going to take a little while before I got this cleaned up, got the ovens cleaned up, and I'm making pizza over there. All right. Excellent. I'm really excited for this, for these projects. This is really good. All right, so this is just the first project. And then I got another project that I'm working on with Black Mouth Design. All right, I'm on the road here, and I am heading over to a company called Black Mouth Design. Rich Bachelor over there. And I've done a lot of work with this company over the years, building all kinds of amazing, cool projects. So we're heading over to their shop, and I'm going to show you the next big reveal here, the next big project for the channel. And this is a super exciting project. All right, a couple years back, I did a project with Black Mouth Design, and we were working on a project for T-Mobile. There's a John's Island Center auto here on Bainbridge Island. Yeah, we were doing a job for T-Mobile where we took an Airstream trailer and we turned it into a frozen yogurt cart for T-Mobile. And we polished this thing up. We redid the whole interior, exterior. This thing just looked absolute dynamite, an amazing project. And then we took it over to T-Mobile's headquarters,
and we lifted this thing up, I forget, maybe to the 15th floor, and we slid it through a hole in the building. It was like a balcony on the side of the building, and we slid this Airstream trailer in, because that was the floor that their lobby was on, where people come in, right? And what an amazing thing this was to lift this polished Airstream trailer way up in the air, slide it into the building. And here I am guiding this Airstream around like it was a balloon in the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. This was just an awesome project to work on. All right, just pulling into Blackmouth here, and this is the big reveal here on the project. It's these two Airstreams right here. This is the project that I'm gonna be working on. All right, here are these two Airstream trailers, and these are awesome. I haven't seen the big red numbers on these guys, but I think these have some serial numbers on them, and we'll be able to figure out a year. But this is the upcoming project. So one of these, I'm gonna be taking over to my place, to my shop, later this week. And this is the project, to take Airstream trailer, polish this up to a mirror finish, and outfit this as a camper, deck it all out inside. Let's take a peek in here. Look at this action. It's all gutted out already. Now this looks pretty crazy, right? Looks like a lot of work, but this is gonna be an awesome project. These are really cool to deck these out, right? Definitely needs a lot of work, no floor, but this is great that it's all gutted, and I'm not gonna have to gut it. All right, let's take a look around here. Here is some serial numbers on this action here. Take a look around the back. Now this one's got some paint on it, so I'm gonna have to strip the paint off of this. Here's this other one. Now this is an Airstream International. This one's slightly different. Tradewind. But nonetheless, an awesome looking Airstream, right? It looks crazy now, but just you wait and see. This is gonna look dynamite. Gonna outfit this whole thing inside and out. These look so great when they're all polished up. Take a look around here. All right, get a good look at this now, because this is all gonna change. We're talking some nice sleeping quarters, kitchen, right? The whole nine yards in here. Now that one that we did for T-Mobile looked just like this. It was the same kind of quality, and you saw how nice that got polished up. Just looking dynamite. These are definitely gonna need some patching, some new riveting. Gonna have to put some new pieces on here. Might reach out to Randy Richard there and talk to him. He's the rivet doctor there after working on all those airplanes for all those years. He's got it really dialed in. Well, there we go. This is the next project. I think I'm gonna start this before I start working on the pizza ovens and the mixer. The Airstream here is gonna come first. So I'm gonna come over here in a couple days, pick this up, tow it over to my place, and get to work. All right, I'm back at the shop here. And as you can see, I have a lot of projects that are in the works. Aren't those Airstream trailers just awesome? And I think the goal is, working with Rich over there at Blackmouth, that this trailer at the end of the project is gonna be for sale. So if you are interested in a trailer like this, stay tuned and travel along on this journey and watch the restoration on this Airstream. This is gonna be an amazing project. You saw the photos of the one that we did for T-Mobile. That just came out dynamite. And this one is gonna be amazing. I'm really excited to start this project coming up here this week. All right, then of course, I've got the great pizza project going on. This is going to be awesome. I'm going to be making a lot of pizza out of this place. I love making pizza. I've been making pizza for years, and this is just a dream come true to set up these ovens. So people local to the area here are going to be in for a treat because they're going to be eating a lot of pizza with me. But right now, I want to take a look back on this past year. It's been one heck of a year, you know, starting this YouTube channel, making all these videos. It's been quite a journey. It's been a lot of fun. So let's take a look back over the past year. As you can see, it's quite a journey here this past year, and those last few pictures there are of my dad, who passed last September, so I owe him a lot of gratitude. That's a big loss for my family and myself, and
just really miss him a lot. And, you know, all this here, it would not be possible without him. Just an amazing guy. All right, as you can see, it's been quite a journey here this past year, you know, putting out all this YouTube content, and I've learned quite a lot this past year in putting out this content. And even in this past month where I haven't put out any content, that taught me a lot too. And it's taught me about where I want to put my time and my energy. And I was putting a lot of time and energy into posting on social media like Facebook and Instagram. And I realized over this past month that I'm not going to put as much energy into that as I was doing. And partly because this shop here is a creative space for me. It's kind of a safe haven for me to come and to work and create. And it reminds me of a book I read years ago called The Courage to Create by Rollo May. And he wrote this book in the 60s, I think mid-60s. And he talks in this book about a mathematician. And this mathematician used to sit down at his desk and try to figure out these very difficult problems. And he would say that, I forget the name of the mathematician, what his name was, but he would sit there and try to solve these, but he wouldn't always come to the conclusion or get the answer sitting there at the desk. But oftentimes, it was in times of silence when he was out on a walk or he's walking through the city or he was on the bus, when he wasn't thinking about that math equation, the answer would come to him. And Rollo May goes on in this book to talk about these times of silence are so important for the creative mindset to be able to have this meditative time, you know, this time out in nature, this alone time, this quiet time is so good for the creative mind. And he's saying in 1966, this is, he's saying, oh, I feel bad because of the advent of radio and so many people are listening to the radio that it's distracting them and they're unable to have these creative times, these times of silence and just going out for a walk. And I think, you know, all right, that's 1966. He's talking about this in the radio. You know, nowadays we got the internet, we got stuff, you know, bombarding us from every angle, right? And so, right, where is that creative time? So he's saying, if you allow yourself this creative time, you'll have a leg up on everyone else. And then you'll also just have this enjoyment of being able to create with a clear mind. So hence with, you know, all posting to all these social media things and trying to advertise my YouTube channel and pump things up, you know, I think it's going to be better for me not to do those things. You know, I'll still go on there occasionally and post some stuff. But at the same time, I think it's going to be better for me here in the shop. And my creative juices will be flowing and a lot more beneficial for me. So this past month has revealed a lot. I've had more quiet time and just working away here in the shop. And so I think that's going to be great for me. I think it's going to be great for you guys, you know, for this channel. And I think that's pretty exciting. So in addition to the machining and the woodworking and the sewing and the pizza making and the Airstream remodeling, I'm probably going to add in some more content that's out in nature. Because you guys have probably seen some of the old Taylor Ham Tuesday episodes that I did where I was hunting around for the champion trees in Washington State. Those were some of the best videos I thought that I did. I just had such a great time going out and hunting for those trees. I love being out in nature. And, you know, for this channel, one of my big goals here is just I want to share, you know, my passion for making things, you know, getting in there with your hands, my passion for creativity. So I'm going to share with you what I'm doing here in the shop. And then I also want to be an advocate for other people to get involved and to be able to get into that space to create things. And hopefully this channel is helping people along that journey. I think it's such a cool thing to see all these guys that are into tool restoration, right? I'm not a huge tool restoration guy. I do like watching those videos. I think they're great.
And but I think it's awesome. There's a lot of these guys who are doing these restorations. I don't even know if some of them were really into tools before they started doing these restorations, but these restorations have pulled them in, you know, to working with their hands. You know, they're watching Scout Crafter there. What an amazing guy he is, showing these people how to restore these tools, giving them all these tips. And so many people are joining in on that wagon there and getting their hands dirty. And so hopefully my channel here is helping along as well with people being able to build things, create things. So, all right, another cool feature that I'm going to be adding to the channel here is that each week I'm going to give my recommendation, my pick for a YouTube channel that I really enjoy. And so I spend a lot of time watching different creators of different content. And so first up is Craig Adams, K-R-A-I-G Adams. And Craig puts out some amazing content of him hiking all different places. And he goes to a lot of different national parks. And I love getting out in nature, hiking, camping. That was one of the big reasons that I moved from New Jersey out west here, was to travel to national parks, hiking, camping, Pacific Crest Trail. I've been to so many national parks. I just love getting out there in nature and checking out these sites. So head over to Craig Adams' channel. Maybe drop a comment, say that I sent you guys over there. And maybe you got a YouTube channel you want to recommend to me. You can drop it in the comments here. I'll check it out, and perhaps I'll recommend that channel here next week. So yeah, tell me your favorite YouTube channels as well. So, all right, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'm excited to be going on this journey with the pizza and the Airstream. So I hope you guys come along and travel with me and watch as this all develops and unfolds. It's really exciting. You know, I'm just excited to be eating some good pizza. All right, so hope you guys are great, and I'll see y'all soon. All right, right on.